Hey cruisers, I'm Sherry with CruiseTipsTV.com. We're currently on board Carnival's beautiful ship, Carnival Panorama, on a Mexican Riviera cruise. But these tips that we're going to share with you today, all about cabin organization and just cabin tips in general, will work with pretty much any cruise cabin on any cruise line. We're in a spa balcony cabin up on deck 14. It's really great. We have access to the thermal suite, and we're gonna do a separate tour of this cabin if you'd like to see it. But the purpose of this video today is to give you some tips and tricks on how to get the most out of your cabin. And a lot of the things that you're going to be doing to plan ahead are things you can do before the cruise to make things a lot easier. Now, if you've been with us for a while, we've been making cruise videos since 2013. You have probably seen a few of our cabin organization videos. So some of these tips and tricks might be repeats for you, but this video is for the newbie cruiser who's just looking to totally maximize the space in your cabin and have an awesome time. So we're going to get started with tip number one, which is to create a wall mount itinerary for yourself. It's hard to say itinerary sometimes. We have a link to make one of these and to customize it. And I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the description of this video. But as you can see, what we've done is put our cruise ship at the top, and we've got our date, destination, activities, and the time and port, or just, you know, pertinent times over here on the right. And we've laminated it to make it just a little bit easier. Sometimes I'll also tuck other paperwork behind it, because what we're doing is we're leveraging the fact that the walls in our cabin are magnetic, and we're using a magnet to hold this to the wall. Now, not every wall in this cabin is magnetic. For example, this one isn't, but this one is metal. So you can stick it right there. And what you're doing by keeping things on the wall is keeping all of your counter space a little bit cleaner. Just makes it so much more tidy and organized, which we love when we're on a cruise. We don't want things to get super cluttery. I mean, you're on vacation, you wanna relax, but we like things to be kind of neat and tidy. All right, our next tip is to take advantage of this little extra space that a lot of people overlook. This is the space that you'll find in your cruise cabin or stateroom next to the bed in your nightstand. As you can see, my son has his books and things in there, and it's just a nice little area that a lot of people often overlook. Another tip for you is that if you have a coffee table in your room, you may love having a coffee table in your stateroom, but you may not. You might find that when you get out of bed, you bump your knees on it. It might annoy you. You may not need it. You can ask your stateroom attendant to have it removed if it bothers you. But let's move on to our next set of tips. We're gonna move over here to the vanity for just a moment, and we're gonna talk about this little drawer right here. Most cruise ships these days have blow dryers, so you might be able to leave your blow dryer at home. These aren't super high powered, but if you have shorter hair or you don't need a fancy hair dryer, this might be enough for you. But there's often a little bit of extra space within this area. We like to put a few little tech gadgets in here, my husband's reading glasses, batteries, ear pods, things like that in this area. So this is just a really nice little spot. Now let's talk about how to keep all of your stuff plugged in and charging efficiently. Not all cruise ships have this many charging opportunities, right? In this particular cabin, we're lucky because we have a couple of standard 120 volt plugs, and we have some USB ports here. But if you don't have that many in your cruise cabin, you might need some supplemental charging. What we've started to do is we've started to pack a USB charging hub like this one here. And as you can see, we have a lot of devices going all at once. Now you could, in addition to that, you could pack a non-surge power strip if your cruise line allows it. But these days we tend to leave those at home and just use our USB charging situation. It just makes it so, so much easier. Another tip that is actually a new tip that we learned on this cruise is to pack a little bit of Velcro with you to keep all of these cables organized. You see how right here we have a little bit of Velcro going around those cables? That's to keep your cables organized. You don't have Velcro? No problem. We actually had a little bit of ribbon with us from our little cruising ducks, and we used some ribbon to organize our cables in a pinch, because it's not something that we really thought of in advance. But from now on, we're gonna bring little Velcro strips with us. these shelves up here are great places to store things like hand sanitizing wipes. We've got a whole stack of face masks here and face masks in here. And then the things that we use the least, we're gonna store up high. In this case, our stateroom attendant keeps putting our beach towels, our pool towels up there. That might be something totally different for you. You could put spare drinks up there, whatever you want to do, but there's always lots of space on Carnival, at least, in these cabins to store your stuff. Now I want to show you the refrigerator on Carnival Panorama. This fridge is fantastic. One of the things that's really wonderful about this particular refrigerator is that it's very tall. Not only is it working really well, but it's tall enough to hold these large water bottles. So if you want to bring your own beverages on board, remember on Carnival, you cannot bring plastic. We actually purchase these on board, but you can bring canned soda still. So feel free to do that. And feel free to bring the allowable wine or champagne for adults as well if you'd like to save some money. I'm gonna go ahead and just switch over here really quick and just show you that we brought a couple of bottles of wine with us to save money, and that's something you can do too. Now, while we're here, I want to draw your attention to one more tip, and that is that you can use these glasses that are provided to you by your stateroom attendant to store things in. We have our liquid IV in here, which is a hydration multiplier that we love to use on cruises. I even have a discount code for you for this electrolyte drink that I'll pop down into the description as well. It's one of our favorite things. So always remember, you can use glasses to store stuff in, and they'll bring you more glasses if you need them. In a little bit, I'm gonna show you how we use these in the restroom to organize toiletries, makeup brushes, and things like that. But now let's head over to the closet for just a moment. There's not a whole lot of tips I have to give you about the closet, but I do wanna just show you inside how we keep things organized. And that is, we simply organize by person. So my husband takes the top two shelves. I take the top shelf here and a drawer. And then my son has the bottom two drawers. So you can organize however you'd like, but for us that just works easier. Now, if you pan up to the top one more time, you're gonna see my husband has employed another tip and trick, and that is that he's left his clothes in his packing cubes. Packing cubes are an awesome way to stay organized, and what you can do is when you get onto the ship, you can just slide your packing cubes right up onto the shelf, open them up, and everything just stays neat and tidy and organized. So we're gonna move over to the next bank of closets here. I'm gonna show you just a few more tips here. Another thing that we like to do is pack a clothes hamper, a very small pop-up hamper that is travel size. As you can see right here, these are just a few dollars, and they're a great way to keep your dirty laundry separate from everything else. Another great tip, if you are traveling with a backpack and you want to get that backpack out of the way, you can put it on the back of a hanger in your closet just to keep it off the floor and out of the way. It's a nice way to just kind of get that tidying done, if you know what I mean. Okay, let's talk a little bit more about how to leverage the wall space in your room. We're gonna move over to this area. As you'll see, Carnival has provided this little hook that has our breakfast room service menus on it. I've just hung my purse on it to kind of take advantage of the fact that the hook is there, keep my purse up and off of the surfaces and out of the way. Now, we also purchased some extra magnets to mount on these metal walls, which we've employed over here. We're hanging our hats on these little hooks. We're hanging face masks and my son's little cruise card over here. Just kind of keep things a little bit more tidy. Another tip about your stateroom here on Carnival is that the staff will tell you that you need to put your room card in here in order to keep the power on, but really any old card will work. You can put your Costco card in there, and you know, anything else that you have. I wouldn't suggest putting a credit card, but something like that is gonna be just fine to put in here to keep the power on in your room so that you don't have to continually remove your key card. Now, of course, when you leave your room, you might wanna take this out as well so that you're not wasting power, right? Okay, now we're gonna take just a quick look in the restroom at a few other organizing tips that we employ in the restroom. First thing I wanna show you is in the shower. We do like to take advantage of the fact that there is a clothes drying line in the shower to keep our swimsuits up off the floor. You don't want to put these on your balcony because they can really easily blow away when the ship gets going or when it gets really windy. So put them in here and not out on your balcony. Now we're going to move over to this door, and I want to show you how we use a few more of the hooks in the room. There's some little towel racks on the back of this door, as you can see, and my toiletry bag came with a little hook that we easily can just hang this up there with and then open this up and use it there. And my jewelry roll also has little hooks on it. So we're kind of doing double duty there to keep things off of the surfaces of our cabin, keep it looking nice and tidy. So come on into the restroom. I'm going to show you very quickly how we organize our shelves. Nothing fancy, but one thing I always like to do is put my sunscreen in one place in our stateroom. Everything else is kind of messy, to be honest, but if I have the sunscreen all in one spot, I feel we reach for it more. The whole family knows where to find it, and that's just what works for me. So sunscreen on the top, and then we have the little toothbrushing and shaving station right here, and then just a whole bunch of random mishmash stuff here. Another thing, if you're going on a longer cruise, is that you can bring your own hand soap. This is particularly a good tip if you're not flying to your cruise, but if you're driving, it might be worth it. As you can see, we've used about 3/4 of this, and we have 2 days left on our cruise. It's just a nice touch because the little soaps that they provide, you know, these little guys, when you leave these sitting out on the counter, they get wet, ooey, gooey, sticky. They kind of dissolve on the counter. They're gross. I don't like them. On a shorter cruise, not going to bother packing this, but if you have the room in your suitcase, it's a nice option. A little earlier, I told you that I used some of the glasses in the stateroom to organize some of my makeup items, and I want to show you how I do that in here to keep my makeup out and easy to access all the time. In this one, you can see I've put all of my makeup brushes, a little comb, and even some lip gloss, and then I have a lot of my more, like, you know, the long, skinny types of makeup, like mascara, concealer, lipsticks, are in this one, and I can just easily reach for them. So it's something that I do on almost every cruise, and honestly, I do it in hotels as well. All right, I hope you've picked up some great stateroom organization tips today. We really love sharing this information with you. And we're going to link to a lot of these products in the description of this video because you may or may not know that we have an Amazon store that is specifically for cruise travelers. So we're really excited to link to all of those and to allow you to shop our cruise store. If you have any questions about cabin organization, you're welcome to leave it in the comments. Better yet, send me a direct message over on social media, Facebook or Instagram. Follow us at CruiseTipsTV and send me a DM, and I will see if I can help you. Also, be sure to check out all of our vlogs and website articles from this cruise. We have trip reviews at cruisetipstv.com and lots of vlogs here on our YouTube channel as well. Thank you so much for watching our Cabin Tips video, and until next time, we'll see you on the high seas.